In this video, we're going to talk about some super easy ways to find money for investing by saving on everyday expenses. And you'll be able to do this without having to cut back on anything at all. And with just two easy areas to focus on, I'll show you how to save, at minimum, an extra $100 a month to invest without changing your lifestyle one bit. Oh, and in 20 years, that extra $100 a month could easily turn into over $50,000. Too good to be true? Stay tuned. Welcome to Healthy, Wealthy, and Wise, where we talk about little things that can lead to big improvements in our financial and physical health. If these are the things you're interested in, you'll definitely want to subscribe and become part of our community. Because, after all, it's free, and it'll make sure you don't miss any upcoming videos. So you want to start investing. Good for you. And to help you, this channel hopefully will be an ongoing resource for you to do just that. We're going to talk about all of those things you have to do when preparing for your future while living comfortably in the present. And to do that, the first thing you need to do is to find some extra money to start investing with. And in today's world, that can be a little difficult. The good news is, if you've been paying attention and have watched the first few videos on this channel, you've already learned some ways to save at least $100 per month to start off with, and maybe you just didn't realize it. Now, I'm not going to say that I always have a rhyme or reason for every video I release or when I release it, but I did want to kick this channel off by giving you a couple of tools that would help you save money up front. And I did that because I wanted you to be prepared for this video, which is on figuring out how you can invest even when you feel like you don't have any extra money to start with. This video can be for anyone, but its focus is really for either the young person that is just recently out of school and is on his or her own for the first time, or for someone a little older that may be raising a family where expenses are tight, but is starting to think about retirement or their kids' college expenses. In either case, the great news is that you're looking ahead and planning for the future, and I hope to be able to help you with that. The last thing I want to say before we get into this, I wanted to clarify that investing is not just for financial purposes, which I know is what everyone first thinks of when they hear the word investing. Me too. And we'll definitely talk about that a lot, but you can also invest in other things, such as your health, by eating better types of food, which tends to cost more than junk food, or through exercising by either getting a gym membership or by buying a good piece of home exercise equipment that you'll actually use. After all, the old saying is true, if you don't have your health, you have nothing. You can also invest in you by seeking to improve yourself through education and self-learning, which is hopefully one of the reasons you are here watching this video. Not everything requires money to do these things, but often having extra money can make it much easier. Whatever type of investment is important to you, we will cover on this channel because this is what I love to do myself. So hit that notification bell so you don't miss any opportunities in learning how to save that money that can help you focus on improving your health, your mind, and finding ways to invest for your financial security. Okay, now if you're like a lot of people watching this and your focus is on growing wealth, the extra $100 a month of savings that you put right into investing can, in 20 years, grow your original $24,000 in contributions to over $51,000, assuming a widely accepted annual growth rate expectation of 7%, which is based on the power of compounding returns and the history of the stock market and inflation. And because I'm going to show you ways how to do that without cutting out anything you enjoy, it will almost be like you got that $51,000 for free. So in the first videos on this channel, we talked about some things that can help you save money that I'm going to expand a little bit on. In the very first video, we talked about looking at cell phone expenses and how to save on them. And then, in our most recent video on saving money, we talked about how to save money on gas for your car. In those two areas alone, I'll show you how I, and you, can save over $1,300 per year, which gets us that extra $110 per month without cutting out anything we need or enjoy, and we'll also talk about how I got savings up to that number. We've talked about a few other things as well, but in implementing just those two strategies alone, I have hard numbers to show you where I found that $100 a month extra, which can then go towards investing. So for the cell phone savings in that first video, we talked about how I switched to a truly unlimited plan by Visible Wireless, which runs on Verizon's network, arguably the best and most reliable network in the country for only $25 a month. Please check out that video to learn more about the Visible service, but for today, we're just going to focus on my savings. Prior to switching to Visible, you could say I was already saving money by being on a prepaid plan on Verizon for $67 a month, which I had mentioned did not have unlimited data, so it actually was an inferior plan compared to what I get now with Visible. I say that I was already saving money because the most recent data I found showed that the average cost of a monthly cell phone plan in the United States was $114. So for me, I saved over $42 a month, which saves me $504 per year. But let's say I had that average bill of $114 a month. Then my savings would actually be $89 per month, or a yearly savings of $1,068. And I'm guessing that some of you might be in that ballpark of that amount. Now, some of you may only have a plan for yourself, but a lot of you may also have a family plan where you have a few cell phone lines that you're paying for. What we know with Visible is that each person with a cell phone could have a monthly bill as low as $25. So the first thing you should do is look at how much more than $25 a month are you spending per person. If you're spending more than that amount, then you can get your bill down and put those extra savings towards investing. So for example, if there are four people in your household with a cell phone and you pay on average $50 per user on a family plan, then your potential savings per month could be $100, and that could go towards your investment plan. And that alone could give you that extra $100 a month to invest. I do want to be clear that there are more options than Visible, which again, I'm not being sponsored by. Visible just works best for me. You need to use what works best for you. If AT&T's network works better for you, then maybe you look at Cricket as a lower cost alternative. If T-Mobile's network is best where you live, then check out Metro, formerly known as Metro PCS, for lower rates. Now I should add, you can save even more if you don't use a lot of data. But that's not somewhere I can go at this point for myself. Yes, I like my technology and I'm not looking to cut that out. Okay, so let's start a tally of savings so far. For me, I save $504 per year on my cell phone plan, whereas, based on statistics, the average user could save $1,068. So now we're going to move on to the second strategy, which is on saving money for gas without doing anything extreme like buying an electric car or motoring down the highway at 40 miles per hour to improve gas mileage. Today, we're going to talk about saving money on gas by using grocery store fuel discount programs. We covered this on last week's video where we talked in depth about this strategy, so if you haven't watched that video yet, you definitely will want to check it out. Again, I'm not going to go into all of the details on this video of the ins and outs of how it works, but I explained how I saved money on gas by buying groceries and gift cards at my local grocery store that went towards getting big discounts on gas. And that one thing alone resulted in me saving $817.53 in 1 year. And in that video, you might remember how I told you I knew exactly that amount through my expense tracking software I use, so I know it's legit. And I will once again reaffirm by saying, no, I'm not crazy for doing that. Now, typically when you use a gas discount program, you have to go to a particular brand of gas station to redeem the discounts. So what you can also use is an app such as Gas Buddy that tracks gas prices so that you can look at the prices between that particular brand of gas between different stations. For me, I have two close by stations that I can redeem my discounts at that are both within a couple of miles of me, and they are never the same price. One is usually about 10 cents per gallon higher. So to maximize my discounts, I always head to the station with the lower price. And as I mentioned in the video on this, I also make sure I get the maximal amount of gas that can be redeemed at the discounted price. All right, let's update our savings tally. For me, just using the two strategies we just talked about, I save $1,321.53 per year, or as we want to look at it, $110.13 a month that I can now use for investing. For the average cell phone user, assuming they drive as much as I do, they would save $1,885.53 or $157.13 a month that could be used towards investing. There's the simple math on how to find extra money doing two things that don't involve us cutting something out that we enjoy or need. Obviously, we can find a lot more savings, and I have a lot more to show you in future videos, but I think the important point here is that drastic changes don't usually lead to lasting ones. And because you're not depriving yourself of anything that you enjoy, these changes can easily last. The gas savings strategy will take more effort, but honestly, I've been doing this for over 5 years and it's been no big deal at all for me now. And once you make the decision to switch your cell phone, there is no extra work to do other than watching to see if your plan prices start to rise. And if it does, then you look to reassess. Okay, so there you have it, an extra $100 a month to start investing. But before you start, are you really ready to invest? Before we take that next step, particularly for financial investments, in our next video in the series, we'll make sure you got everything in order before you start investing. Definitely hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on these upcoming videos. I hope you found this video helpful. And if you did, please hit that like button, share with your friends and family, and subscribe to the channel. Let us know in the comments section what things you've done to save money. I know I'm always open to learning something new. Again, I hope that we can all learn from each other on how to take little, easy steps in making big improvements in our lives. Thank you again for watching, and until next time, have a great day.